we cannot go back to that matter and entertain it. That one stands as far as official. The decision stands on what the court held on the very first gazettement. A matter of particular interest in that ruling, dated 15th of May 2019 by Honorable Murigi, Chief Magistrate, is the order arising from the prosecution application dated 16th of April 2019, which are reproduced below. One, the first respondent, this is the Governor of Samburu, is barred from accessing the Samburu County Government offices without the prior written authorization from the CEO of the investigative agency, that is ESEC, who shall put measures, if any, in place so as to ensure that there is no contact between the first respondent with the prosecuting witnesses and preserve the evidence until further orders of this court. I've added emphasis on that. Two, Director of IFMIS is hereby directed to bar the respondent from accessing the IFMIS platform. Three, an order, the Governor CBK, is hereby directed to bar the respondent from accessing any of the Samburu County Government accounts. And four, each respondent that's the accused before this court as well as co-accused are barred from contacting or in any other manner interacting with any of the prosecution witnesses, either directly or indirectly, and in the hearing termination of this particular court. Those were the orders that the previous trial court had issued. In my humble view, these orders confirm the orders previously granted by the plea court, Honorable Douglas Ogot, Chief Magistrate, dated the 2nd of April 2019, which was as follows. The accused will be released on bail term that shall be fixed shortly. Court will give the following interim order to safeguard the integrity of the trial. Since Samburu County offices is where the crime took place, I'm quoting, the governor is hereby prohibited to access those offices till the application to be directed to be filed is heard and determined. And since it is public money that is involved, director of IFMIS directed not to allow the 13th accused person to access the government of Samburu accounts till the application to be filed is heard and determined. And DPP is to file a formal application and have it served on the accused person, and thereafter to seek confirmation date and direction of the application court and the appeal courts on those orders by the plea courts. Recently, in Nairobi Criminal Appeal Number 109 of 2019, the case of Moses Kasaine and Nampula of the Republic, decision by Court of Appeal, it appealed the ruling that was rendered by the High Court in Nairobi High Court, ESCEC, Revision Number 7 of 2019, that the Judicial Mumbi. As well as this court ruling in respect of the bail terms granted to the first accused person. The Court of Appeal rendered thus, I quote, likewise, we too are satisfied that both court below properly exercised their discretion when they took into account the appropriate principles or guidelines on bail. Further, we can find no wrong in the two courts' application of the national values and constitutional imperatives set out in Chapter 6 of the Constitution to arrive at bail terms imposed after all. Under both Articles 10, 1b and Article 259.1 of the Constitution, courts are duty-bound to take into account the national values, principles of governance, and the Chapter 6 principles on leadership and integrity when applying the provisions of the Constitution. The Court of Appeal, quote and end of quotes, the Court of Appeal went on to state, quote, we would agree, having found as we have, that the bail term did not remove the appellant from office, but merely required compliance with the constitutionally sanctioned terms, that of necessity limiting his access to the county offices until determination of the trial. We find that the learned judge sufficiently addressed the issue by pointing out the relevant constitutionally crafted remedy, quote and end of quote. For the avoidance of doubt, the prevailing bail terms then granted to the first accused person are to be construed from the court's ruling delivered on the 15th of May 2019, as well as the High Court ruling in Nairobi ECEC, Revision Number 7 of 2019, delivered on 24th of July 2019. The previous trial courts and the Court of Appeal were categorical that the bail terms imposed by this court, in effect, limited the first accused physical access to the offices of the county government of Samburu. In addition, The first accused was barred from breaching the witnesses and interfering with evidence. Thus, so far as the interpretation of the bail term is concerned, the foregoing literal meaning must apply without any more room to stretch the meaning of the term access to office to include suspension of duties, except in express instances where the governor is prohibited by the bail terms. And I will elaborate. For example, the question of access to isthmus, that's one of the clear examples, the question of access to isthmus. On those duties, that one is limited and is suspended from accessing the isthmus. On careful evaluation of the supporting affidavit, this court finds that it is not persuaded that the scams of this case, there is evidence of interfering in any manner with the prosecution witnesses. Application falls short of demonstrating that there exists any compelling reasons to warrant a review and or cancellation of the bail terms granted to the first accused according to the threshold that we have seen on the case law. On a scale of justice, this court is inclined not to grant the order sought by the prosecution, and accordingly, this application, dated 13th of December 2019, is hereby dismissed for lack of merit. So that's the ruling and the decision by this court.
Most obliged, Your Honor.
Most obliged.
Allow me to write an application.
Yes.
Your Honor, I wish to apply.
Just a moment.